Young man, you met a girl. It was very clear. Speech is simple.
Why don't you understand
this? Come on! That's one. Now we have this play, young man. You are the ball handler. So all I need you to do is take the screen from the center, move into the free throw line extended, then you can have an open shot or pass to the man cutting. Do you understand? That's coaching. Nine times one. Nine times two. Nine times three. Come on! Do you not understand simple nine times seven? Switch. Or, 9 times 1, it's 0, 9. So, there's a T to 9 times 7. All you need to do is add 1 to the left side and take away 1 from the right side. So it goes like this. And 9 times 2 will be 1, 8. You understand?
Yes.
9 times 3, you do the same. Add 1 to the left side, take away 1 from the right side. And it's 27. 9 times 4, you do the same. You add 1 to the left side, you take away 1 from the right side. 9 times 5, you do the same. You add 1 to the left side, take away 1 from the right side. Do you understand? Thank you. So, I am a teacher and I am a coach. I'm a better teacher because I am a coach, and I'm a better coach because I am a teacher. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Issa Fofana, and I'm here to talk to you about how we can fuse education and sports to have better outcomes. So in 2011, upon finishing my secondary school education, I decided on attending the summer basketball camp at the National Stadium. So I was excited, and this was a new challenge for me in life. Well, I took a part in an inter-school basketball competition a few months earlier. Well, unfortunately for me, my performance was pretty uninspiring. So I did not really receive an official invitation, but I was asked to tag along by a friend. On the first day, I went till 30 minutes late, saying, well, it's Sierra Leone. I'm probably the first to come here. I stepped into the court, then bam! I was slammed with a fine. I looked up, saw a shabbily dressed man, and he said to me, training starts at 8, and at 7:55, you are late. And I thought, he must be mad. But then he said, you are fined 200 euros. And that confirmed my earlier suspicion, that he is indeed mad. But the first day went on, and straight away started explaining the physics of basketball, things like biomechanics, how our joints work, why you need more joints if you want to pass further, why you need more joints if you want to shoot from a further distance. Then during the first water break, he started giving us life lessons. Then I realized he knew his stuff, and I was in total awe. At the conclusion of that day, I said to myself, I had just met a legend. 1 week into that particular training camp, it was clear to me and all of those paying attention to me why I did not receive an official invite to that camp. Because my brain was processing what was being said, unfortunately, my body was not executing what my brain was processing. So when they were splitting us into different teams, I was sent to the last team. And the team was called the Green Team. We know green means war. So we are the war players, or the squads. But as we were in the green team, when they were giving us the instructions, I was explaining to my teammates what to do. But I was not doing it. I was just able to communicate it. So the coach noticed that and told me, well, probably you have a career on the sidelines. So it will be better if you stand by me. So it began. I went to the sidelines by him, saw what he was doing, then he started teaching me the nuances of the game. As fate will have it, 5 years after that, we started a basketball team. Me, as the coach, and the players from that particular camp back then. So, we have played for 3 seasons, went to the semifinal of 4 seasons, and we've won back to back championship. Why is he the only one now? For that second part, in 2016, I started off as a research and teaching assistant at a university in Sierra Leone. So, as a teaching assistant, I was asked to handle some scripts, examination scripts. And the inability of the students to actually express themselves in the simplest of terms had a very strong effect on me. Also, my interaction with the faculty members was very disappointing, to say the least. We had lecturers coming to classes unprepared, some others using the same notes for years without end, while some others would say, well, today I'm tired, so I'll not bother to go through all of the scripts. I know their names, I know their abilities, so I'll just grade them according to their needs. But unfortunately also, the students were equally uninterested in learning. All they wanted to do was to move to the next level by any means possible. Nothing else mattered. They will tell you, well, I'm here for the paper. I will learn later. But as I continued to teach, I started seeing similarities between teaching and coaching. Then I realized that at the most fundamental level, both of the fields involve passing on a certain message to a group of people in a way that they will understand, and also creating a platform where they will grow and maximize their potential. Then the question started to flow. What if we replicate a team culture in an academic setting? What if we break down the wall between teachers and students and create an open channel for communication and interaction? Then what if, as teachers, we genuinely care for our students as coaches do their players? So today, I'll just say three things that we can focus on that will help us to have better outcomes. The first one is passion. So I'd like to ask, did any of us play sports here? If you play sports, just put your hand up. Okay, you can now put your hand down. Did you play this sport because you like this sport? Put your hand down. Did you play this sport because you think this sport is lucrative? Anyone? We have one hand. See, two, three. That's it. So most of the hands are now down. So we see that people going into sports generally do it because they have passion for that sport. If you talk to the top players, the best of the best, they'll tell you, I love my sport. I like to be in the gym every day getting better. So Kobe Bryant, 18-time NBA All-Star, 5-time NBA champion, 1-time NBA regular season MVP, 2-time NBA Finals MVP, and who played 20 years for the Los Angeles Lakers, surefire Hall of Famer, once tweeted, he was asked a question on Twitter. The question was, why do you do what you do? Then he said, because I love doing what I do. Then someone replied to his tweet by saying, well, don't get it twisted. You are only in it for the money. Then Kobe replied, do what you do, do it well, then the money will follow you. Then he said, hashtag, you got it twisted. So, in sports, people generally do it for passion. Unfortunately, education in our country, we have three streams. It's the science, the business, and the arts. We have been conditioned to think that if you are going to the science stream, you have to do something lucrative. It's either medicine or engineering. Well, these days they say, well, IT looks marketable, so you can do that. When you go to arts, it's law. And if you go to the business, it's accounting. So we see we have people doing things that they don't have passion for. And when they hit the proverbial wall, they cannot push through. So I believe education in this country can learn from sports by focusing on passion rather than the profit margin. The second point is discipline. So Jim Rohn said, discipline is the bridge between goals and accomplishments. So as a teacher and as a coach, you have to discipline yourself to get better every single day. You have to learn new methods. You have to research. And you also have to hold your players accountable. Because if you allow them to cut corners, skip training, skip bills, it's going to hurt you and the players down the line. The same goes for the players also, because it's a two-pronged approach. If you have the best of coaches and you have players who are uninterested, then you are not going to make any progress. The same goes for education. If the teachers are trying their best, but the students are uninterested, then it's not going to make much of a difference. So you have to be disciplined personally, then you have to hold others accountable. You have to hold your players accountable. So education can learn from this. First of all, us teachers need to be disciplined. We need to study. We need to prepare. We need to research. We need to find new methods to pass on messages. And also the students need to do the same. They need to discipline themselves. Go to classes, learn, read other things that are even out of the scope of your work. And develop yourself. Then the teachers also have to hold a certain standard of discipline for the students in the classroom, during examinations, etc. Then lastly, developing the rhythm. So there is a saying that a chain is only as strong as its weakest link. And that is a saying that us coaches subscribe to. In basketball, you have 5 players on the court at a time. If you have a weak player or a player with a certain weakness, the other team is going to exploit that weakness. So we'll keep on attacking that weak player over and again, over and again, over and again, till we get what we want. So as coaches, we focus on developing not just our star players, but every single player on the team. So that when that player's name will be called up, come game time, he will be able to deliver. So I've met some well-meaning academics trying to teach well, but some of them are a bit frustrated and saying, well, we are in a dystopia, there's nothing we can do to change. Salono Pueblo. So what they do is, when you go to class, you find one or two of the good students, then you focus on them. Try your best to develop them. Well, the others, they can do what they want to do. But what we must know is that that person is going to be somebody one day. And if that person is not well prepared, he or she is going to be a squad there in a long run. So I believe, as teachers, we should also find ways and means of reaching to each and every one of our students and helping them to grow and to get better. So we all know Sierra is a country stricken by poverty. And because of that, many people think, or we've all concluded, that education is the only way out of the grip of poverty. And sports is seen by some as a pastime and by others as just a waste of time. But I believe it is high time that education takes a page out of the playbook of sports. So if you are an educator, a teacher, if you want to get better, do some sports or pay attention to sports. And if you are a student or a pupil and you want to get better, do some sports. Yeah, thank you.